गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टुडेज इंग्लिश क्लास. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैड रेड यू द हाफ ऑफ द लेसन. सो इन दिस क्लास आई विल बी रीडिंग द अनदर हाफ ऑफ दिस लेसन. एंड आफ्टर दैट वट एवर वर्ड्स आई हैड गिवन यू द हार्ड वर्ड्स, आई हैड सेड यू टू राइट दोज हार्ड वर्ड्स एंड टू फाइंड दोज मीनिंग्स. सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट दोज मीनिंग्स ऑल्सो. सो हियर आई गो विद द next half part of this lesson. Hear it properly. Keep the textbook with you. Whenever I am reading, just keep the finger on that line and hear to the pronunciation. Malati sang beautifully. She had a melodious and well-trained voice. Rima and her gang had decided to jeer when Malati sang, but there was such absolute silence they did not dare to. They were sure to get caught. When Malati finished, the principal was the first one to start clapping, followed by the teachers and students. No one was surprised when Malati won the first prize. Rima did not come first in her category somehow. She felt no joy. As the term progressed, it was abundantly clear to all that Malati was a bright child. She was quiet, studious, and intelligent. She fared well in sports as well as in studies. Her forte was mathematics. Her simple appearance belied a sharp and nimble brain. Slowly, many of the girls began seeking her help in mathematics, help which she readily and cheerfully gave. The teachers had liked the respectful, intelligent girl from the beginning. Now, girls from the class also befriended her. Not Rima and her clique though. They stubbornly disliked Malati. They were a stylish lot, and nothing that Malati did could alter the fact that she was not their type. They never lost a chance to poke fun at her, particularly her English. Malati felt bad about their behavior. One day, she was on the verge of tears when Rima mimicked at her mercilessly because she said "ax" instead of "ask." Her voice trembling, Malati said, "I know my English is weak. Yours is good. Please, will you help me to improve it?" "I won't be able to help you, my dear," replied Rima with an exaggerated accent. "Speaking proper English isn't easy for you countrified types." Malati's face turned red. She wanted to retort but could not find the right words. She burst into tears and ran off. "That was horrid, Rima," said Shehnaz. "Yes," agreed Neha and Claire roundly. Rima was shocked. Her own friends had turned against her. She walked off in a huff. Mrs. Sen found her subdued over lunch but decided not to ask anything. Rima knew that she had behaved very badly. She was too proud to admit it, even to herself. I'll read it once again. Hear it. Malati sang beautifully. She had a melodious and well-trained voice. Rima and her gang had decided to jeer when Malati sang, but there was such absolute silence they did not dare to. They were sure to get caught. When Malati finished, the principal was the first one to start clapping, followed by the teachers and students. No one was surprised when Malati won the first prize. Reema did come first in her category. Somehow she felt no joy. As the term progressed, it was abundantly clear to all that Malati was a bright child. She was quite studious and intelligent. She fared well in sports as well as in studies. Her forte was mathematics. Her simple appearance belied a sharp and nimble brain. Slowly, many of the girls began seeking her help in mathematics, help which she readily and cheerfully gave. The teachers had liked the respectful, intelligent girl from the beginning. Now, girls from the class also befriended her. Not Reema and her clique, though. They stubbornly disliked Malati. They were a stylish lot, and nothing that Malati did could alter the fact that she was not their type. They never lost a chance to poke fun at her, particularly her English. Malati felt bad about their behavior. One day, she was on the verge of tears when Reema mocked at her mercilessly because she said "ux" instead of "ask." Her voice trembling, Malati said, "I know my English is weak. Yours is good. Please, will you help me to improve it?" "I won't be able to help you, my dear," replied Reema with an exaggerated accent. "Speaking proper English isn't easy for you countrified types." Malati's face turned red. She wanted to retort but could not find the right words. She burst into tears and ran off. "That was horrid, Reema," said Shahnaz. "Yes," agreed Neha and Claire roundly. Reema was shocked. Her own friends had turned against her. She walked off in a huff. Mrs. Sen found her subdued over lunch but decided not to ask anything. Reema knew that she had behaved very badly. She was too proud to admit it, even to herself. Here ends the reading of this lesson. I will be sending you the hard words from the other half of this lesson. I want you all to write the hard words 3 times and their meanings 2 times in your notebook. Now we will be discussing the hard words meanings of the first half of this lesson. I had given you as first one shrugged. Shrugged means ignorance, raise shoulder slightly. Sometimes teacher is there in front of you and your friend asks you something, and then you are not able to talk in front of the teacher and you want to say yes, no. Then what you do, you raise your shoulders and you say, right, no, or I don't know. So that is called as shrug. You are ignoring. Next one, inquire. Inquire means ask for the information. Grimace. Grimace means an ugly, twisted expression. When you are not happy, you are angry, you make your face somewhat different. That is called as grimace. Next, mimic. Mimic means imitate. Whatever one person is doing, you are trying to do the same thing. That is called as mimicking or imitating. Next, glance. Glance means take a brief or hurried look. Just see suddenly and then turn your head on the other side. That is called as glance. Insufferable. Too extreme to bear or intolerable. You can't tolerate that situation. That is called as intolerable or insufferable. Sigh. Sigh means deep, audible breath. We had discussed this in the first poem. Sigh means you are taking your breath deep and then you are leaving it. That is called as sigh. Next, chorus. Chorus means you might have heard the songs, and in the songs background some people are singing. That is called as chorus. And that chorus is being repeated. A part of the song which is repeated is called as chorus. Beam. Beam means shine or a ray or shaft of light. A beam of light. From one hole, light is coming. That is called as beam of light. Next, giggle means laugh lightly and repeatedly. You all might be doing this giggling slowly when teacher is saying something and you want to laugh, but you can't laugh loudly, so you laugh very slowly, or you make a joke and you laugh and you continue that. That is called as giggling. Offend. Offend means cause to feel upset. You are making someone nervous or you are making them feel bad. That is called as offend. Cattily, in a way that is unkind, means you are not talking with the other person in a kind way. You are talking very rudely. That is called as cattily. Next, flush. Flush means become red and hot. When you are angry, your cheeks and your forehead, your tip of the nose becomes red. That is called as flush. Next, atrocious. Extremely bad or unpleasant means it is very bad, or you are making someone feel uncomfortable, unpleasant. Snob, a person who believes is superior. You might have a friend who thinks that he knows everything or she knows everything, and he or she considers that they are great than you all. That is called as snob. Next, sneerily means false or unworthy. You make someone feel unworthy. That is called as sneerily. Now, these were the meanings of the previously discussed half part. Now, again, I'll be sending you the hard words of the other half of this lesson. I want you all to find those hard words, meanings, and also to write them. I hope you all are clear with this. Also, I had said you to read the questions and the meanings which are given on the right and left corner of the lesson on each page. I hope you all are doing that.